I'm Anita Mahadevan-Jansen. I'm Orin H. Ingram Professor of Biomedical Engineering at Vanderbilt University. I teach biomedical engineering undergraduate as well as graduate courses here at Vanderbilt. So I teach several different classes over the years, especially. The course that I am most passionate about is the use of lasers in medicine and biology. So it's a course that addresses using light and with lasers as well as other kinds of light for solving problems in medicine. And so it's a course focused on undergraduate students, both juniors and seniors typically, who take it as an elective course. It's still very state-of-the-art, so while there's fundamentals to be taught, you also have to teach it in the context of applications that are more current and modern to keep it exciting and interesting. Often I think what we decide to do as a teacher is based on who our teachers were. So I come from a background, mostly at least for my high school, undergraduate, and even early graduate education from India, where it's very didactic. It's very, there's the professor in front of the classroom teaching, very taxonomy based. And the expectations are high in the Indian educational system in general of what is taught, what is delivered, and what is expected from the students. So when I started teaching here, that's the model I knew. I knew what were pieces of it that I didn't like, but that was still the model that I knew. And so going in, that's sort of what I went in doing mostly, getting in front of the classroom, teaching to a topic, having problems, which is something I enjoyed doing, so I expected my students to enjoy doing. So giving lots of problems along the way, but still very old-fashioned traditional model of teaching. You know, no surprise to some extent, although I was surprised at the time, students did not like that approach when I first started teaching, and in fact, dinged me pretty badly. As a teacher, because I think partly because my expectations were high, but partly because you think that, I think as a young, early teacher, you think the more you teach, the more effective somehow you are. Just topically, you know, just finishing, covering more material means you've taught more. But it took me probably the first couple of cycles to realize that less is actually more, that if I teach less but make sure the students really understood the less that I taught, that's more important than making sure I covered everything on my list of things to teach. That was probably one of the first lessons I learned before I did anything more in terms of my teaching and my development as a teacher, I guess I would say. So the biggest reason why students have trouble with the didactic approach in general, I think, is because it's out of context. To me, that's by far the key thing is, you think, you know, on the first day of class, you talk about the class syllabus and you tell them you're going to teach this topic and that topic and then after that, this third topic. They don't see the context of why in that progression. Why do I need to learn this? To me, that is why you lose students often when you go with a pure didactic approach from day one. When they go to a pure math class, you know, often, or a physics class, they're typically used to that. You know, they know that first comes electricity and then comes magnetism and then comes Maxwell's equations, let's just say, right? But why do you need to know the Maxwell's equations? Or why do you need to know this? You know, I'd often get this question, you know, you talk about the lens, how a lens works in optics. And I remember going through this when I learned optics for the first time with this didactic approach. You drew this lens and they showed you how the lead ray trace went when you shine light in, what happens to the light on the other side. And I go, well, I'm not going to be an optometrist or something. Why do I need to know what's the lens formula, right? That's sort of, to me, the classic reason why didactic approaches fail, because it's material taught without context. And anything you do to change that approach makes a huge difference, even if it's something as simple as just letting them read something. But the more you can do with context, the more effective I think teaching is. So traditionally, at least what is often is you go and read the chapter in the book, right? At least in the more taxonomy-based courses. Now, one of the reasons why my optics class in that case was always a challenge is there are no textbooks for what I was teaching. The course used to originally be called Introduction to Biomedical Optics. Well, there weren't really any biomedical optics textbooks. So you were picking chapters from this book and a little bit from that book, but still the reading material typically used to be focused on reading some kind of book chapters. Often these book chapters were written for graduate students or higher, or professionals, So the undergraduate student wouldn't necessarily grasp the material. But that's the best you had. So that's what they, you know, that's usually that was the most of the outside class. You would give them derivations of equations to do out of class, or problems to solve that were based on these equations or concepts. But that's really the kinds of out of class material that you did, because I always loved problems. I'd always give them problems, mm-hmm. but often those problems didn't necessarily have a resource to go to. So they'd struggle with that, and I think they would blame me often for not covering the didactic material in class and leaving them to struggle. So I'll start by saying, you know, I came away after about the first 2 years, 3 years of teaching, frustrated as a teacher because somehow I wasn't connecting with my students. It wasn't working. I had started to recognize through help some of the things I needed to change as me. As I said, I needed to change who I was, how I approached my classroom, how I dressed even, how I talked. But I needed something more.